My name is Walter Rolka and I'm from the Department of Health Sciences Research at the Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota. Today I would like to talk about a paper that is upcoming in the Mayo Clinic proceedings entitled The Prevalence of Multimorbidity in a Geographically Defined American Population, Patterns by Age, Sex and Ethnicity. In this article, we describe the prevalence of multimorbidity involving 20 selected chronic conditions. We use the Rochester Epidemiology Project records linkage system to identify all residents in Olmsted County in southern Minnesota on April 1, 2010. We then extracted electronically from the system the code of the International Classification of Disease 9th version associated with all of the healthcare visits of the people living in the county between April 1, 2005 and March 31, 2010. So we looked at a window of about 5 years. Using these ICD-9 codes, we were able to define 20 common chronic conditions recommended by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services. These conditions were selected at the federal level because they are common, because they are chronic, and because they may be amenable to preventive or therapeutic interventions. In particular, we consider hyperlipidemia, hypertension, depression, diabetes, arthritis, cancer, cardiac arrhythmias, asthma, coronary artery disease, substance abuse disorders, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, osteoporosis, chronic kidney disease, stroke, congestive heart failure, dementia, schizophrenia, hepatitis, autism spectrum disorder, and HIV infections. If we look at the county overall, we have about 140,000 people living in the county, and about 39% of them, considering all ages, had at least one or more chronic condition, 23% had two or more chronic conditions, and about 5% had five or more chronic conditions. The prevalence of multimorbidity, if we consider it as two or more conditions, increased steeply with age and reached about 77% at the age of 65 years or older. However, if you look at the absolute number of people affected by these chronic conditions, more younger people are affected than older people, of course, because the biggest segment of the population is below age 65. The prevalence overall of multimorbidity was very similar in men and women in terms of numbers, but if you look at the composition of the combination of morbidity, this was different in men and women. And also, if you look at the prevalence of five or more conditions, this was higher in men than in women. Compared to whites, the people categorized as black had a higher prevalence, and the people that self-categorized as Asians had a lower prevalence than whites. So what are these findings telling us? Well, the finding from our study may prompt changes in the planning of clinical services, in the way we deliver care, and may also prompt some revision of the current guidelines. Many of the current clinical guidelines tend to focus on one disease at a time, and by doing that, they sometimes may be inadequate, and they cause the use of conflicting drugs or they propose interventions that conflict with other conditions. From the patient perspective, our findings are also important because patients have to be aware of the consequences of having multimorbidity. That means having more than one chronic condition. For example, especially young people should be very concerned about the appearance of multimorbidity, because at that time it's still possible to intervene by either treatment of some of the conditions or by modifying some of the behaviors and the lifestyles, which would then help them prevent additional morbidity to appear. And this, of course, can lead to changes in things like diet, lifestyle, exercise, and other habits such as smoking or other behavioral factors. From a research perspective, we need to emphasize that these findings are coming from a cross-sectional look at the population, so they represent like a picture of what happens in Olmsted County at one point in time. We are now looking into the actual frame of development of multimorbidity, because we want to know how people transition from being healthy to developing a first condition, and then how they transition from having one condition to having two conditions, and from two to three and beyond. So we are really planning in the next phase to study the causes of multimorbidity, which are the factors that predispose to the appearance of multimorbidity, especially in younger adults. And then we want to look at the consequences of multimorbidity, looking at what happened to these people 10, 15, 20 years later in terms of need for care, admission to hospitals, admission to emergency rooms, and admission to nursing homes, and finally death. In summary, we would like to emphasize that multimorbidity is common in the general population. It increases very rapidly with age, and it is similar in overall numbers in men and women, but the specific combination of the conditions does vary quite a bit in men and women. Also, the more extreme combination of four, five or more conditions tend to be more common in men than women. We feel that better understanding of the causes of multimorbidity, of the determinants of multimorbidity, and of the consequences of the long-term sequelae of multimorbidity is a very important and urgent topic. Thank you.
We hope you found this presentation from the content of Mayo Clinic Proceedings valuable. Our journal's mission is to promote the best interests of patients by advancing the knowledge and professionalism of the physician community. If you are interested in more information about us, our homepage is www.mayoclinicproceedings.org. There you will find access information for our social media content, such as additional videos on our YouTube channel or journal updates on Facebook. You can also follow us on Twitter. More information about healthcare at Mayo Clinic is available at www.mayoclinic.com. This video content is copyrighted by Mayo Foundation for Medical Education and Research.